Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. It's been a little while, and I've been slammed with emails, but I got one in particular I want to talk to you today about. Vendor reached out, and I'll, let me see if I can put this on the screen real quick. Let's see. All right, so I don't know how this will do. Let's see. Okay, so it says it's from Ben to Ben. It says, hey, Ben, we're struggling as vendors for no reason. There's always a reason, okay? So there's always a reason, and it's always fixable. So that should give you a light at the end of the tunnel, and it's a real short tunnel. Probably going to be solved right now. To give you a little background, it says, my dad and I have lost our job due to the pandemic. Many people have, and I completely understand, and I hate that for you. It's crap. Hold on just 2 seconds, because I forgot to turn on the chat, and I can't see nothing. It's probably better I don't have it on, because then I don't get sidetracked. So we'll see if I have this going now. It looks like I do. Yeah. See, look at that. Les from Bark Car here. Alrighty, Les. All right. So my chat seems to be working. Keith G in the house, Roy's in the house. Rick is in the house. Edward Hayden, Mario, Roy, Johnny. Thanks, y'all, for being here. Okay, so here's the deal. I'm going to finish reading this email. He says, I know you receive thousands of emails a day. I don't receive thousands. Sometimes a couple hundred. And we're reaching out to you because you are the silver lining in the struggles as being a hot dog vendor. Well, we have tried many locations, including Family Dollar, Tractor Supply, grocery stores, and even events with walk-by traffic. And I'll show you a picture real quick because he sent me one. Here's an event. Hopefully this was taken when there was no walk-by traffic, because I'm not seeing a lot of walk-by traffic, but this looks like an event, because I see some other vendors, and it looks eventy, right? It looks like an event. So, let me see. I got to figure out how to get rid of that. All right. So, yet we have only sold $100 sold, and maybe probably 70. We cannot crack the code to why we don't get enough sales, but we know you can. We need your help. Benjamin and I think it's Avi. Avi is what I'm going to go with. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. And then here's some pics of our setup. One of them I showed you. They have several more about the same type of setup. They show me up close to the cart. What I prefer when I get these is, when somebody sends me something like this, I need more information, and you'll see why during this video. I've done many cart critiques for vendors, and I need to know more information. I love to have the address where you set up, or roughly where you set up, okay? Because I can Google Earth and Google Map that, and it kind of gives me an idea of the area. Then I look at, I want to see a pictures of your cart set up from a distance, okay? So I want to see what the surrounding area looks like with your cart. What are customers seeing, or potential customers seeing, from a distance? Okay. And I don't mean 6 miles away. I want to be able to see you still, but I want to be able to see what others would see from the road or from the sidewalk, down the sidewalk a bit. And I'd want to see up close, like your menu, that kind of stuff, and see how you keep stuff. You know, is it neat, clean, and tidy kind of deal? So, because in my experience, when vendors go out there and you go, $60 a day is crap, okay? Unless you're just doing 30 minutes to an hour a day, then it's okay. But $60 a day ain't good. Plus, even if you were only out there for an hour, you still have prep, cleanup. You know, there's more than an hour involved. So now you're 2 hours, so $30 an hour is good, but you need more than 2 hours a day for a living, right? You can't survive off $60 a day. So we need to figure out what the issue is. And so what I did is I emailed them back. Well, I didn't, I emailed them, but I sent them a video, and I want to show you a piece of this. If I can figure out how to, share this. Let's see. I don't think this is. No, I want to show. Right here is what I want to show, probably. Nope, that's not what I want to show. I want to show. Dadgummit. I don't know why this thing doesn't work for me sometimes. Okay, so let's do it this way. Let's go to here. And I'm going to show it to you this way, hopefully. Because I want you to get an idea what, here's how I respond. Here's what, in case you were in the same situation, you'd know what to send me. Plus, you'd know the answers. Because watching this, you're going to have all the answers. So, let me see if I can pull this back up here. Yeah, that's what I wanted. Perfect. Okay. So maybe you're seeing that correctly now. I think we all are. So this is that. This is what I sent him, and I'm gonna fast forward through part of this, just to give you an idea. Just to tell you what this is I use an app called BombBomb, and it allows me to, if it's a long answer, I don't want to type it all out. So what I'll do is typically send back a video reply just for them. This is what I replied to Benjamin and Ollie.
Hey, Ben, thanks for the email on learnhotdogs.com or the YouTube channel. This was a couple days ago. You'd see that what I asked for and why I ask, and you'd see the results. And oftentimes, people that have needed help like this in your situation, they've found that the answer is already in one of those critiques. 99% of the time, it's the same answer. It all comes down to signage and the way you're set up. I don't know how y'all appear in this, so I don't know what it looks like. Like, if you're sitting there, to give you an example, I had a guy send me, I asked for pictures of his setup, and he sent them and at a distance and different angles, and I got all those. But then I asked him to have somebody take a picture while he's there vending. Well, he wasn't busy at the time, you know, when he had the picture taken, so he had his wife go out in the parking lot and take a picture. And he was in there with, you know, it looked to be a stained up shirt, and it just looked gross. Like you wouldn't want to walk up to him and get hot dogs.
I'm going
to
skip around some of this.
Y'all look neat and presentable. Okay. Clean, neat and presentable. It's typically signage. What I would do, I'll put a link right below this video.
So what I'm going to show you what I linked him and everything and spare you my, slow answer that I gave him there. Let me go back out here to this, and this may help. Okay, so he sent me, I asked for more pictures and stuff. He sent this from a distance, and this is him with his cart, and they have a nice menu sign, okay? But I'm going to show you their video, so you can kind of see the walk around, because he sent me a video as well. After I responded with a video.
Here's the street view. And this is our little setup over here.
Now, it's called I'm going to pause this just for a second, because that's their sign. Okay? Now, you heard my response. It usually comes down to signage, and it usually does, especially if you're a brand new vendor. Once you have a following and people know, okay, that you know, Hillbilly Hot Dog's going to be at Tractor Supply on Thursdays, they just get used to it, and people just come to expect it. And other people seeing other people there makes them want to come up. But when a cart is sitting by itself with one little sign, it's hard to do. Now, we're going to talk about something else here, too, in just a second, but I want you to see the rest of this.
You're such an inspiration. There's our sign. Here's the street view. And this is our little setup over here. It's called Hot Dogs on the Cart. And You have cheese right here. Chili. And best of all, hot dogs. Hey. And we sell them for $2 a piece. That includes toppings. And obviously ketchup, mustard. We have drinks. Here's the full walkthrough. You walk around the cart. I'm just struggling.
Now, if you notice, the cart is neat and clean, okay? The cart is neat and clean. The area around them looks neat and clean. And there's a reason I'm saying that. So that's really about it. So let me see how to get rid of this video now, if that's possible. Oh, right there. Okay, so there's several things that you need to look for, and I've pre-written these so that we could go through them together. This is your three typical things. There is a fourth one, and you know what? While I'm here, I'm gonna put it up. So cleanliness is part of setup, but it really should be separate. So I put that on here. So here's what you've got is you've got location first. Now, he's already stated in the email I read you that he's tried all these different locations. So now we know it's not about location. We know it's more about the setup, signage, or cleanliness. That's what it comes down to now. Because location, he's tried several locations. And because they've both tried these locations, I had assumed that, like he talked about auto parts stores and grocery stores, well, those have walk-by traffic. But the video that he sent me, he's relying pretty much on drive-by traffic, because where is the sign? The sign is between the sidewalk and the road. So it ain't for the people walking down the sidewalk, which I doubt there are many, but he's trying to get traffic off a road. Well, what is the one thing I say about getting traffic off the road? It's hard as hell. It's hard as hell to get people to pull over in the midst of their day to stop and eat, okay? And here's how I often say, if you're in a really good spot and you're easy to get in and out of the parking lot, because that's what you're going to need if you're going to have the drive-by traffic be your customer, then you are going to, you can test this, is you can put free hot dogs out by the road. And I bet if Ben and Avi put free hot dogs out by the road, said free hot dogs, I doubt their business would increase much. As far as, I doubt they would sell many more or give away many more hot dogs than they currently sell. The reason why is because the setup doesn't look that good. Now, I'm not beating up Ben and Avi. And I'm sure Ben is listening. He's commented on YouTube videos this morning, probably four or five times. So, and he doesn't hide his name or anything. So I'm sure he'd be okay with this, and he'd know that I'm trying to help. I just wanted to point it out to you. I'm not trying to be a jackass. So, if it comes down to location, I'm going to pick that grocery store he talked about. I'm going to pick the auto parts, but you're going to want stuff that's busy between 11 and 1. If that's lunchtime, okay? It's pretty much that way, you know, around the world. You don't really want to be trying to compete for dinner time unless you're a full-fledged cart set up where you got burgers and chips and dogs and walking tacos and a full-fledged deal. But in the beginning, I wouldn't go after that crowd. Most people are thinking other types of foods by then. Lunch is where vendors make the most money in the beginning, and many keep it that way forever. So lunch is your key time. Well, if you're not in a place that's seeing a lot of people between those key times, I've had vendors pay the big money to Street Eats, which has changed names three times, but now it's called something else, Canteen. Canteen is the new name. It was Best Vendors, and before that was Street Eats. But they managed Lowe's and Home Depot's. Well, I've got vendors that have paid the big money to them, Canteen, so that they could vend in front of a Lowe's, but they didn't do their due diligence first, and they found out Lowe's doesn't even do 30 customers. Their Lowe's may only do 35 to 40 customers on the lunch hour, the 2 hours. Well, that ain't enough. You'd have to have all of them buy, and maybe buy twice, to make a good living. So it comes down to where you set up. And so you've got to do some homework there. And it's great that they've tried other locations, but I tend to think it's the setup. If I saw that setup, I would not pull in there. Now I would, as me, because I freaking love hot dogs and vendors. And so I'm going to pull in and talk to them. But the average Joe, my wife, is not going to pull over to a vendor that has one handwritten sign and a little cart, especially if she's driving down the road and wasn't planning on stopping in that parking lot anyway. So maybe if she was in the parking lot already at another business and walked out to it. But if those surrounding businesses, even those that he showed across the road, aren't this one right here, this picture, I'll put this back up so you can see. So you see these businesses across the road. Well, that's got breakfast, lunch, and dinner right across the road. Not that it's the end of the world. You're kind of competing with a restaurant, but they don't look that busy either. And it's a food mart. Okay. Those are typically good places to be as far as convenience stores, but that convenience store looks dead. It looks like the owner's there and maybe a couple other people. So I don't think there's enough business for you there. But you've got to be, if you're going to pull that traffic from the road that drives by, you've got to spend the money on the signs. You have to have stuff that looks appealing. If somebody misses that handwritten sign, they're going to miss the rest of it. Okay? So that little handwritten sign is fine, but I'd want bigger signage. I'd want hot dog meal, all beef, $5 or $9 or whatever your prices are. And I would not, I'd go to a vinyl shop and say, can you make this for $35? And they probably can. You probably wouldn't have to spend much money. Could you make it yourself out of cardboard and magic markers and some stencils? Yes, you could probably get it done for $6. Okay. You wouldn't want to keep a cardboard sign forever, but if you had to make one every day, it'd be worth it. If you had to take some $1 balloons and hang from the sign, you want people's eyes to see that and them go, oh, I gotta stop there. I got to turn around. And that's the other problem with locations where you're looking for people to stop is you got to look at the speed of the traffic going by and how convenient is it for them to either turn around and come back to you or get in and out of your parking lot. Do they got to cross 9 lanes of traffic and 4 turn lanes and wait on 16 different light sequences before they can turn in? And how hard is it for them to be able to leave? People think through this stuff. There was a lady in Florida. There still is a lady in Florida. Okay. And she was in our Vendors United group and she was struggling in front of an Advance Auto Parts, struggling. And I've told this before, but hear me out. She was struggling. She didn't want to move. She didn't want to try other locations. She said they had a lot of business. Well, the lot of business wasn't during the peak hours, so it wasn't helping her that much, but she was really hoping to pull from the traffic out front. We had her move 4 spaces over. I told her, I said, I want you to, she sent me the address, and I Google Earthed it, and I looked at the, I even did the Google Street View where it appears like I'm in the Google car and I can kind of see, I couldn't see her because obviously she wasn't there when the Google car went by, but I could see the Advance Auto Parts. I could see where she would be the first place I'd see her if she had been there. And I was like, oh, that ain't going to work. They won't see you till they're almost to the, they'd have to slam on brakes, bow up, stop traffic and hope nobody rear ends them to get in there. Okay. If they were stopping for just that reason, because the person that's coming to an Advance, he's already got his blinker on a block ahead of time and he slowly gets in, right? But these people don't. And that other lane, that inside lane of traffic doesn't know. So we told her to move 4 spaces down it changed everything for her. Her days went from these 60, 80, I think hers were around $80 a day, and she was miserable with that, and I don't blame her, to $300 to $400 days. It changed everything, just moving a few spaces. So, and later we added signs, or she added signs, and it did a lot better. But what I'm saying is, if you're going to rely on that drive-by traffic, you must think about what that customer is thinking. That person driving down the road, they're going somewhere. They're originally left wherever they just came from. Their intention was not to try to jerk out of traffic and get into some hard-to-get-to place to pull up to a cart that they can't even tell what you got till they get up there. Okay, so this is why it's important to have signs. Swooper flags are brilliant. They eye-catchy, and they say hot dogs, or they say lobster rolls, or whatever you're selling. So you've got to have some of that, and yes, you'll spend some money. Borrow from Mamaw, do whatever you got to do, because it's kind of like, can you imagine if a McDonald's spent all that money to get started, and you've spent money on a cart, you've spent money on inventory, you've spent money on your business license and your health department license, but you didn't put it in the parking lot. McDonald's said, yeah, we can't afford the parking lot right now. It's basically a moat. We're hoping people will just walk through the moat and get over here to us. They ain't going to do it. So you gotta know that it's part of the business. But I see a lot of vendors slack right here. They get all the way up to the point, and then they're like, man, I don't really have to have signs. I mean, let's just try it without signs. And they do it without signs, and then they're calling me. Or they quit. Go to hot dog cart, our page, hotdogcartsforsale.com, and you'll see all the people that are quitting. Okay, those are people quitting. Now, some people are quitting for different reasons and whatever, but I guarantee you the people in there quitting ain't because they made a lot of money. They weren't making lots of money and quit. They're just quitting. So now some of them are health issues or something like that. So I don't want to put everybody in the same barrel. So now let's talk about the setup. When they walk up, it still doesn't look inviting to me. I'd have a little fold-up table, you know, a flip-up table, little small one, you know, maybe borrow one from the church or somebody and put up a table with a little tablecloth and some condiments out there and stuff. It looks more inviting. It is not the priority, though. I'd still have signs. I'd have signs, and then I'd change freaking locations. Now, you didn't send me the address, Ben, so I have no clue about the actual area. I couldn't do a Google drive-by. So I would do that. Cleanliness, overall, everything looked clean. Even your one in the park, this one right here. Let's see. This one. This picture here is in, it looks like a park or something. I don't know what that is. It's some kind of memorial. There's a cannon. Anyway, this is a great setup, okay? But signage is lacking still, okay? People sometimes, I'm okay with handwritten signs, but I guarantee you this. This sounds chauvinistic almost, but typically females have better handwriting, and they'll make them bubble letters, you know, especially if you find a female about my age, because in high school and in grade school they all did bubble letters, you know, those big bold letters that look fancy and it shows off. If you're going to do a sign handwritten, make it nice. If you can't do nice, or you can't write nicely and neatly, go get you a stencil set at Dollar General. Just get a simple stencil set at Walmart or wherever and put that, make your sign simple. All beef, hot dogs, $2. That's simple. Okay. And maybe make four or five of them. Okay. Do things like that. The balloons off of them, stuff like that. That's one of the things. So let's see here. There was more I was going to show you. Okay. This is one of his comments from today. Okay, this is 4 hours ago, roughly. He says, hey, guys, so he has no problem letting us know, you know, he needs help. And I love it when people don't let their egos get in the way of getting help. They just put it out there. So Ben does that. Ben says, hey, guys, I'm really worried about vending. I mean, Ben may know what he's talking about, but I don't may know what I'm talking about. Okay. There's a lot of crap I don't know. Ben, a lot of crap I don't know. I know vending. I know it frontwards, backwards, sideways. Do I still learn? Absolutely. But I know freaking vending. Okay. Here's what I can tell you. If you said, okay, we'll prove it. Here's $10,000. Prove it. We'll put $10,000 up. You go make a $400 day in my town. I'll guarantee you, I'll go make a $400 day in your town because it's doable everywhere. And y'all are going, $400, I'd be tickled pink with. We have a vendor in our Vendors United group who's upset that his average is $450 a day. And last night during the show, he brought it up. He goes, look, guys, I need help. I wanted to make more. My average is $450 or $440. I want to make more. What can I do? Well, it wasn't signage or anything, but we told him what to do. The point is that you can make a lot of money. You've got a gold mine sitting in that cart, Ben. You have an Avi. You've got this opportunity. You need to think through this and go, what of the stuff Ben said hit home? What hurt me a little bit, stung a little bit? Our signage. I'm sure that stung a little bit because it sucks. Your signage sucks. In fact, I don't even think it sucks because you don't really have any. Okay, so it's worse than sucks. So anyway, he says, but I'm really struggling. Only been vending 4 months, and the most I've sold has been $180, and that wasn't food. As far as that was total, $180, not what he made. Am I doing something wrong? Only averaging $60 a day. After watching their, which makes me feel good, he's keeping up with his numbers because he knows what his average is. Okay, after watching the critique videos, here's what I said to him, and I was a little snippy here. Okay, so get on board. After watching the critique videos I sent you, what did you change with your setup? How many people between the hours of 11 to 2? Because, see, I sent him this. This was 3 days ago, okay? 3 days ago, I sent him that original video I showed you. How many people between the hours 11 to 2 walk by or near you? Are you attempting to stop moving traffic? What's your social media links? I need to know. And I didn't get any of that. Instead, I got this, I need help, which is what I got 4 days ago. So it kind of irked me a little bit, but he meant well, and I think he missed something in my... in the video or something. He missed the message a little bit. Here's his menu up close if you'd like to see it. The menu, well written, easily readable, nice menu. And I look at this and I go, then why the crap you got this cardboard sign that looks like you drew it with your left hand and with your eyes closed? You can't do that. I think that's it. So I already showed you his video of his walk around. And you know what? For those that haven't seen that yet, I'm going to play just a little piece of this because it's not long anyway. But I want
you
to see.
Hey, thank you so much, Ben. You're such an inspiration. There's our sign. Here's the street view. And this is our little setup over here. It's called Hot Dogs on the Cart. And... yeah, cheese right here.
So that's all you need to really see is the fact that the location does not, to me, look like woohoo. I want to see more people. Now, if it's drive by traffic, that may be where all the people are, but you're gonna need to get their attention. Okay, we've talked about in learnhotdogs.com. This information is free. Okay, you can go to learnhotdogs.com. And type in bandit signs, and I don't sell them. I'm just saying that those are good for people that need to stop traffic, especially traffic if it's doing 60 miles an hour. Okay, I put bandit signs out because where my wife and I set up when we first started was right in front of a tire shop. I've got videos and pictures of all that for you at Learn Hot Dogs. But and I needed to slow down these people driving 60, 65. So how I did that is with bandit signs further down the road. So they knew I was coming up before they got to me. It wasn't a bow up and stop. I didn't have an ideal spot at first, but I made do with it because of signage. At first, homemade signs. Absolutely. Don't have a problem with it. You need them to be neat and clean. Okay. You need the sign to look legible and not look like, because if they go, "Hey, just put that sign on a garbage bag. I wonder what his hot dogs taste like." They're not going to get to find out because they're probably too scared at that point. So I'm telling you, you got to think through some of this stuff. Now, there's areas. We have a vendor in Georgia, okay? And it's not Michael Wood, but he's a friend of Michael Wood. And he has no signs. He has no menu. He doesn't have a social media page, and he makes a good living vending, okay? But it took a long time to build that up. He had dedication, determination, and he could do three times the numbers he's doing now if he did just a few of these things. But he's an older gentleman, and he doesn't care, okay? He's happy with what he's got, and I'm happy that he's happy. So this is what you've got to look at. So you've got location, setup, signage, cleanliness. Those are the things. Let me give you something cool. And you may be going, "Man, I wish I could see more critique videos." Well, guess what? If you're watching on YouTube, in the description, I have a link to all the critique videos I've done. And you'll get to actually see video critiques of these other vendors. And you're going to pick out a common theme. It's typically signage. But we had one vendor who had really good signage. He was in Florida, near Orlando, Florida. And he was in our VU group. He was struggling because he was in outside of Orlando, kind of in a rural area of that area. Okay. So it wasn't a really great location. And he was trying to stop highway traffic, which was a lot of tourists. But there was nothing near him, no stores, no gas stations. It was kind of just a gravel lot off the side of the road. And you'll see those pictures if you go look. So what I had him do is make it look neater and cleaner. And I had him buy remnant carpet, outdoor carpet, you know, indoor, outdoor carpet, the fuzzy look, looks like AstroTurf, okay? And I had him put that down. It reduced the, not through the whole strip of the road, just to where he was, so that it cut down on dust, but it also made his cart just stand out. Because here's all this just basically weeds on the side of the road, and then pine trees in the background, and long highway, two-lane highway, okay? And this gravel area, or sand, it was mostly sand, like a sandy area off the side of the road where people would pull over to let their dog poop or whatever. So he's there with a cart trying to stop traffic. Well, he did a few little tweaks like that, and it changed things for him. And so you can make a bad location good, but it may take more effort. I'm all about finding, that's why that cart has wheels on it. Okay. It's so you can roll that sucker right on down to the next spot. And I don't mean change locations every day. I'm saying do it methodically, do it thoughtfully, figure out where to put it, because there is nothing, there is not a soul on this planet that is doing crappy that I can't show how to change it. I'll put money on this. There ain't a vendor in our Vendors United group that has been vending a while that couldn't do the exact same thing I'm saying here. They could go to any vendor in the country at any location in the country and make their cart make more money, because it's just a few little tweaks, small little tweaks. And you've got to go, I'm not going to limit the potential of my business. I'm not going to hamstring my business and my operation because I didn't put signs or I didn't take the effort to find three better locations. Okay. Spend your time off driving through town, looking at what's available. Maybe take 2 days off and go look at some lunch spots. Where's it hot? Where is there lots of traffic during 11 to 1 or 11 to 2? Where is it busy? And then you start to go, okay, I can do it. And I don't mean 5,000, 10,000 people are there, because you ain't going to serve that many people at one time. I'm saying find a spot that, let me give you an idea. A pawn shop in our town does really good between 11 and about 1, because people get off lunch and they need to go pawn something in, okay, their ex-boyfriend's, you know, class ring or something, and so that they can get some money. And so there's a vendor there at that pawn shop. Well, why? Because it makes good money. I used to be there because it made good money. So it was because they had a lot of people. And I'm not talking about hundreds. I told you just a second ago, you don't need 5,000, 10,000 people. What you need is maybe 100 people that come through the door. Not all they eat, but 100 people that come through the door between 11 and 12. And then 12 to 1, maybe 60 people. You need enough traffic that you can pull out some of those that are going to eat with you. And then you can get better and better at this. Tidal Pond places. There's so many places, check cashing places. There's so many places do really well during lunchtime. But I have a whole list for you. And it's free. That's free too. LearnHotDogs.com. Type in the word location in the search box and you'll pull it up. You'll pull up all the different locations. You'll pull up our top locations. Okay? It doesn't mean the other locations won't work. It just means here's the ones the vendors are making the most money with. We do have some vendors making a ton of money with these, but not as many as we do with these. You see what I'm saying? Let's see. John, Art answered you. John asked a question about the commissary and wanted to know, he said Georgia requires, every state requires a commissary. It's easy to get, and most of them are free. Georgia's a little bit trickier, but Georgia also has incubator kitchens. So you can go that route. I have all that. If you type in the word commissary at learnhotdogs.com, you'll see one entitled A New Way to Get a Commissary. It was new, you know, when I wrote it. But let's see. Kevin says, I put my regular dog. I'm going to put some of these up real quick, and then I'm going to go. I know I've went long, but I wanted to give Ben and Avi enough information, but also if maybe there's something, maybe you're doing 250 a day and you want to do more, okay? Maybe one of these little tips will solve that for you. I put my regular dog $3 alone or $7 for the combo. Awesome. Kevin, that's freaking awesome. Dennis says he lost sound. Hope not everybody did. Josh Wood, you're welcome. Thank you for saying so. It's very kind. Rick says, what about the appearance of the vendor? It's absolutely crucial. And in the very first of this, I showed y'all the video that I sent him back, and I explained a vendor that needed help. And when he had his wife take a picture of him sitting at the cart, one, he had a lawn chair that looked like he was setting up at a camping spot. Okay, that's how he looked. And he had a white t-shirt on, like a wife beater t-shirt, right? With stains on it. That's what I saw. Who's going to come up to that? Unless they just got, you know, come out of a jungle and ain't ate in 45 days. They might come up, but the rest of the people ain't. So, Rick, great comment there. You can, to people that are asking about how to contact me, you can email me. Ben@VendorsUnited.com. Ben@VendorsUnited.com. Also, think $2 is low for an all beef dog with the toppings. It is low in some areas. Some areas it's a must. Like you go to, there's some spots in West Virginia. We've got vendors selling dogs there for $1.50. There is a vendor in Kentucky selling dogs for $1. Okay, I don't agree with it. I think he can get more. He says he can't. Now, he makes good money. He stays busy. He's near a coal mine place, and he's busy. But $1 a dog, I mean, I'd assume he should be. We have vendors that are charging for a quarter pound dog all the way up to $6-$7. We have vendors doing those. I found a convenience store that has a lot of traffic because they sell cheap cigarettes. Larry Davis, that's a great one. Justin Mack said, I got my sign from Vistaprint, created it myself. Justin, great one. Yeah, Vistaprint has a great way to create them, right on their site. Amazon has good deals on swooper signs and flags, helped us. Jay, you're exactly right. It's one that I try to tell people to go to is Amazon. You can get really good deals on a lot of stuff. Manny says, hot dogs saved my life. Absolutely. Thank you. Where's the best price to get swooper flags. Charles, it changes the best price to get swooper flags. If you just Google hot dog feather flag, a lot of people call them feather flags. Some call them swooper flags, but either way, I have a friend in Georgia that calls them flutter flags. But you won't find that typically on Google. If you will go and look up Google, it usually pulls up some ads right at the top, and some of those will have lost leaders where they're selling them dirt cheap. Somebody recently got one for $49 or $47. It wasn't one of those 15-foot when it was a 10-foot or a 9-footer, but it's still, it's something that gets out there and gets attention. Yeah, that one that picture I showed you looks like an event, and the other is his actual street location. Look, Art Makepeace says 60 for a hot dog swooper flag and pulling kit at Amazon. I don't know if that's the 9 or 10 or the 15. The 15-foot swoopers are just kick butt. I do 5 to 10 dinner in neighborhoods invited and brewery. Justin Mack says lunch at Kohl's and GFS 11 to 3. See, that's because you got a plan, Justin, and that works. We've got vendors right now that are doing these, you know, homeowner association subdivisions, these, you know, and people are buying these dinners. Those work great for that. But as far as a day-to-day location, pre-COVID-19, the street vending, if your streets ain't shut down yet, you can make good money. You just got to find where the people are. Ron says, I have a cart, but I also have a fear. Guess what? Fear stops a lot of people. I have got a video that's entitled, Oh Shit, I Have a Cart, Now What? And it's because that is a common theme. You get a cart, it all sounds exciting, man. I'm going to go make so much money. And you finally get your cart and your license and everything. You're ready to go. And you're like, oh, shit. What do I do now? I'm actually going to have to do this. What are people going to say? What are people going to think? I was worried to death. Like, my ego was killing me that, oh, my gosh, I'm this lowly hot dog vendor. Well, I ended up figuring out it works to our benefit. It works so freaking good. It's when I came up with the tip jar, and I'm positive that I didn't invent the tip jar. What I'm saying is it occurred to me, people felt bad for me. Well, yeah, we stopped. We know you and your wife are on, you know, having bad times. We stopped to give you, you know, support you. And I was like, thank you. And I was like, ding, ding, a tip jar. And so I put a tip jar out there, and there's a common misconception that vendors don't make that much money. And so, you know, it's like almost like, oh, crap's gotten so bad for him, he's got to vend. And yet we got vendors making $250,000 a year in our VU group. So you go, well, so you want, I'd ride that. I'd ride it. Don't worry about the fear. Because guess what? It goes away. Once you get out there and you start interacting with people, if you like people, it becomes so easy and so fun. It's something you start looking forward to doing. Not all the cleaning pans. That ain't the fun stuff. Okay. But the other stuff is fun, and it's fun interacting with people, serving people, giving them a good value. Okay. And making a good income. That's fun. That's the reward. Okay, I got to put this up here. This art. Okay, he says my location didn't do good at first. Why is my color so freaking wonky doodled? I'm gonna change this a little bit. Okay, just bear with me. I'm gonna change this to that and save it that way. Nope, that didn't work. Oh yeah, you can read that better now, can't you? My location didn't do good all the first week, but hung in there the second week and started getting repeat customers. And over in the last 2 months, sales have increased every single week. Art, freaking congratulations. It's awesome. Keith, you're exactly right. The fourth one or the fifth one should have been social media. That should have absolutely been on that list that I did. Now I can't find my list. Here it is right here. Y'all bear with me. I'm going to add this because it needs to be said. So social media is working really good for people, especially since COVID, because many vendors and many businesses, period, had to turn to something because the normal things weren't working. So social media started working really well for vendors. Some have been using it for a long time. Others said, oh my gosh, what is this, TikTok? What is this TikTok thing? And vendors are using TikTok. Vendors are using Instagram. Vendors are using Facebook. And you don't have to use them all. Pick one, stick with it, use it, have fun with it. Facebook works great, okay? Especially for free marketing. It is great for free marketing. Find a group in your town. Find, you know, I'm sure you have groups in your town. I don't care if you're in Paducah, Kentucky. I don't care where you live. You can put up, find a group in that town. It'll say Paducah, Kentucky, buy, sell, and trade group. And you go in there and go, oh my gosh, we just got a car. We're going to be set up. We're licensed, blah, blah, blah. We're going to be set up at the Advance Auto Parts. We're going to be set up at the Harley Davidson store. Or we're going to be set up here at the Dollar General. We got a vendor over, and he is killing it at an Aldi's right now. Y'all know what Aldi's is? It's one of those new grocery store chains. And he's killing it. So I'm glad you said that, Keith. Thank you. Let's see. I think that's it. I think I got it. Anyway, I love you. Know this. You being an Avi and anyone else that's facing trouble getting started, you're something's just not clicking, right? Something. There's always a simple answer. It may be three simple answers, but it's always something simple that you can do that changes everything, that changes the whole concept, okay? We've got a vendor in VU right now. She's been vending a long time. She does good, but because of COVID, her main location shut down. She could not be there anymore because it was inside of a business, not like indoors, but inside of their plant thing. So that dried up. It took a little bit for her to figure out where to be. She just had her best month in ever last month, ever. So there's always a solution. So do not dare think, I got to throw in the towel. It just doesn't work here. Hot dogs don't work here. You'd be wrong. Okay. Don't give up on yourself. You can make a lot of money doing this. You can be super successful. You can be happy as heck. Now, the only reason I'd rather you quit is go, Ben, I've made too much money, or Ben, I don't like paying the high tax bracket, or Ben, I just don't like vending. Then that's okay. I mean, it's any of it's okay. But the point is then I go, okay, well, you were doing good and you're leaving because you don't like it. There's pilots that quit flying planes because they don't like it no more. So don't worry about it. I love you. Have a great week, and reach out to me anytime, and I'll try to be more consistent on here. I know I did 5 days worth of YouTube comments today, 5 days worth. So I'll talk to you soon. Bye.